Hello everyone, welcome to my channel The Heart of Art. And first I would like to thank all my subscribers, viewers and my students. And today's tutorial is about the best out of waste. So for this activity we will be using a plain shampoo bottle and pumpkin seeds. Okay, so now let us take a shampoo bottle, wash thoroughly, peel the stickers over it and just clean with a cloth so that the glue part is removed completely. Once the glue part is removed everything, we can start our activity. So no need to paint the shampoo bottle as it has its own color and the color is very bright, so we can use. So whenever we cook the pumpkin, we tend to remove the seeds and throw it. So you can take those seeds and you can wash it and you can dry it. So once the seeds are dried in the sun, and you can use the seeds for this activity. So now entire wrapper is removed from the bottle and now just you can take little 1-2 drops of sanitizer to clean with a cloth, okay, so that the glue part is entirely removed. Now after this you can take the pumpkin seeds, then a fevicol, or you can also use the glue gun or the fevicol, it is up to you. So now the bottle is cleaned thoroughly. Now I have taken the glue, I will be using the glue here, the fevicol glue, and I will be doing a simple white daisies. Okay, so now I have taken the pumpkin seeds and I'm just making a daisy. So in between the petals I'll be using a black bindi as my center of the flower. So now I'm arranging the petals to make a flower using fevicol. Okay, you can use the glue gun also if you have. So I'm just making a flower. You can do 1 or 2 flowers on the bottle depending upon your size of the bottle. So it's very important to arrange the petals in a circular form as we are making a flower, a white daisy. Okay, so similarly you have to make one more flower, and once it is stuck you can dry it for some time and then you can color with white acrylic paint. Okay, so similarly now I'm doing one more flower, okay, using fevicol and placing a black bindi at the center of the flower, and I'm arranging the pumpkin seeds as my petals over it. So similarly you have to complete it, and for the petals you can use white acrylic color, and in the center you can use the black bindi. So once you finish your sticking part, you can just make it dry. Okay, give some time for drying, then you can paint it. Then with the stem and all, you can use a thin cotton thread, okay, and you can cut the thread into pieces and you can arrange as a stem. And so once after adding the stem, you can add some leaves. So to make leaves, you can take 2 pumpkin seeds and place it together sidewise, and wherever you want leaves you can add. And you can also have a bud. So for bud you can paste 1 pumpkin seeds at the top of the leaves, and similarly you can do 2-3 places wherever required. And you can take now white color acrylic paint, since the first flower what we have made is dried, so you can start painting the flowers so that by the time we come to leaves it will dry. Still my seeds are little bit moving, but you should see that it should dry completely. And now take a thin cotton thread where we are using this for stem, to make a stem. So you just take the distance between the flower and the leaves and just cut. So try to paste with the glue. So I have taken a cotton thread, now I am just sticking it, and whatever the extra part is there I am just trimming it off. Okay, the thread is passing through the leaves towards the flower. Okay, similarly wherever required, like stem, from flower to the leaves, you can to the bud, so you can paste it. So now I am pasting a cotton thread from the flower to the leaves, then I am just extra thread, I am trimming it out, and I will be placing a bud here. So one pumpkin seed I have pasted. So similarly, wherever you require stem, you can use the thread and you can add leaves using like pumpkin seeds as leaves. And whatever design you feel like doing it, you can do it. It is your creativity. I have done a simple flowers and buds. Okay. And so now once this is done, I'll just leave it for drying for some time. Once the thread and everything is dried up, you can just color the leaves green. Okay. You use green and light green you use, because the bottle is already dark green. So if you don't have a lighter green, you just add yellow to the dark green so that it will have a lighter shade of leaves. So that the bottle background and the leaves will different. So the leaves will be highlighted from the background. So now I am painting the green color, this green. To this green you can add little bit of yellow to have a double shaded leaves. Okay. So once it is like dried, you can also this. So now I am just painting all my leaves with the green color. Okay. And you have to color the bud white. Since the flower is white in color, you just paint the bud with the white color. So now I have just painting the thread, everything green. Okay. You can also select some other design also. So now I am placing a bindi at the center, one more bindi. Okay, so that my flower will be embossed and the middle part will be embossed a little bit more. So now I am pasting the bindi, black bindi. With a glue also you can paste, or directly you can peel the sticker and you can keep it. So now I'm just adding one more stem, like a bent stem near the base, at the base of the stem. So you can do, you can add some more leaves. Yeah, once after adding leaves, you can add one bud there. Okay, just to have a attractive look, I'm just adding that white and black combination flower on the dark green background, so it looks good actually. And when you add little yellow to the leaves also will be highlighted, so it looks more attractive. Okay, whenever you are using this vase, better you just fill the bottle with little sand and you can use it, because the bottle is little light, right? So when you put flowers or anything, the decorative material inside it, it may fall down. So it's better that to have its weight, so you can fill the bottle half with sand and you can decorate it. I mean, whatever flowers you want to keep or whatever material you are using for you are using, right, like a vase, right? So now almost my vase is ready. So just once after painting it, I have to keep for drying. Once it is dried up, you can just take a earbud and just dip it in water or anything, just clean the sides, whatever the sides paint is stuck to the bottle, right, the extra paint on the bottle, just you can clean it so that it will have a better and neat look. Okay, now I'm coloring the buds also. My buds are white. Okay, so now it looks very pretty. And if you want, you can give one more coating so that it will be very bright. Okay, so the extra paint is stuck to the bottle while painting the flowers, you can just clean it so that it looks more clean and neat work. Okay, it will give you a nice look actually. Okay, you can clean it with a small earbud, a cotton bud. Okay, now this flower is ready, everything looks very pretty. Now you can also select some other design, not only this simple flowers, you can also do a sunflower, or you can also do some pictures or any characters. Not only using pumpkin seeds, you can also do papaya seeds or different variety of seeds. for watching my video and making the homemade clay. Thanks a lot, a good job. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe.